Hey everybody, welcome back. Now that we've written our setLED assembly language function, it's time to again use our debugger and use the features of the debugger so that we can walk through that assembly language code line by line so that we can understand what's going on, what we're doing to the registers, and see how all of that works. So let's go back to our Visual Studio Code. And if you recall, one of the things that we did, we had set up this setLED as a stub function, and now we have a real assembly language function, so we can remove this stub function. In fact, if we compile this, we'll get an error. But now that we've finished through that stub function, let's go through. The other thing I had noticed, I had forgotten to put an increment here on the LED num, so I added that in here. So if you notice a change, I had forgotten to put the increment here, so I added that back in. All right, so let's go through and start our debugging session. So we go through and do this. The other thing I should mention is that because we're now going to be turning LEDs on and off, I'm going to try to create a bit of a video overlay of the Hi5 One board going through various changes as we turn the LEDs on and off so that you can actually see it happening on the board that I have attached to my system. And so let's see if we can get a debug session going here. So we've got no error, success. So the debugger is getting started, and voila. So just like before, we've got a bunch of warnings here. We'll turn that off since we know that those don't affect us. And we're going to go through and walk through this line by line. So we'll go through here. We set through. Now, I'm not going to go through setup GPIO again. We've already gone through and done the single step through that, so I don't want to waste the time to go through that. So we're going to step over that. And then when it comes back, it's going to allow us to start going through the set LED. And the first thing we're going to do is set the LED, the first one, and turn it on. So let's step through our code and go do that. Again, just to go a little bit quicker here, we understand that we set up our stack frame. We save our return address. Now, the first two things we're doing here is we're loading our GPIO control address. That's our main memory address. And then we get the current value of the bits or the LEDs or any other bits that are set there. And that's what we load in here. Now, we were passed two things. We were passed the color of the LED and we were passed the desired state on and off. And one of the things that's interesting here is that these came into these registers, A0, A1. And the way you find that out is two ways. One, the RISC-V reader that I keep mentioning, it has a definition of all the registers, what they mean, and that's one of the things you'd find out in there. The second thing is just set up a function and start debugging and look at the registers here down, and you'll see that the values come in, and you'll notice that your values sort of show up here in the various registers. So you can see in A0, we have this 8 and then 4 zeros, which represents our green. And then A1 is set to the value of 1, which means on, or LED on. And so those are the parameters that we were passed to our function. So the first thing we want to test is, hey, is that register actually equal to LED off? Because if it is, then we want to go down here and turn off the LED. And so it should not branch. So it is not equal to 0. And so it should just keep going, and it did. But now what we want to do is we want to check to see, did we actually get a request to turn on the LED? And so we're going to load a value of 1, because that's what an LED on is. Now we're going to say branch if equal. So if the value of A1, which was passed to us, and it's down here, and the value of T2, which we just loaded here, there, if that is, if these two values are equal, then I want you to branch to the LED on area of the code. And so that's exactly what should happen to us. And poof, that's what happened. So now we're in LED on, excuse me. And what we want to do is make sure that we're only addressing the bit that we want changed. And so we go through there. Now this is a line of code that would turn on the green LED. So in the inset video, I'm going to turn the video on now. What should happen is that we should see a green LED turn on as we push go, and voila, we have a green LED. Now, we also know if we got here, we have no errors, so we're going to load the no error into A0. So remember I said I was going to show you how to return a value, and that's it's that simple. You basically load register A0 with the no error, which is typically a zero value, and you're basically done. So we go through and say jump to exit, and then in our exit here, we reset our stack frame and our return address, and then we go back to our function. So everything went cool. So now let's go through and see if we can turn off our LED. So I'm going to scan through here. We're going to go through this quickly, set up our GPIO, get our initial value. Now what should happen is A1 is equal to 0 because we want an LED off. So this should branch to LED off. So let's verify. And yes, that's exactly what happened. Now we want to do the LED off. We have to do an inversion here to make sure we only address the bit that we want to change. So we set up our XOR. So we basically have every bit on except for, in this case, the green bit. So we go through and that together. So that way we only address the value of bit. Now when we write this value, we should get our green LED to turn off. And that's exactly what happened. So now we're going to, again, load a no error. We don't need to have a jump instruction because we're returning back from our function. And then we go back. So now we can see if our LED num is greater or not than LEDs. And so now we can restart our loop. So now we're going to restart our loop. And what should happen is our red LED should come on. So let's single step through that. And now again, I'm going to scan through this fairly quickly here. We have an LED on request. We branch to LED on. We select the bit. And then we see that the red LED. And then we exit out. And now we should be able to turn off our LED. And so we scan through. And we're in the LED off. We write that value. Then we're off, we come back. So now we should be able to do the exact same thing with the blue LED. And so let's scan through and just make sure that that's what happened. So we want to turn LED on. We do this, we're at the on value. We write that word and voila, we have a blue LED. Then we jump to exit and then we come back and return. Now let's make sure that our LED turns off. So now we should have an LED off request. And that's what happens. And so now our loop should start over, and we should have a request again for a green LED that comes in. And so let's just make sure, and then we'll stop. So we have an LED on request, and that LED on is now a green. All right, so I'm going to jump to exit, go through, and then we'll turn that green LED off. And then we'll stop cycling through. All right, so let's stop our debugging session here. And what we want to do is make sure that we can actually get an error value to come back, because that's what stops our while loop. So we're going to put in that bogus value here. I'm going to change this off, on off, and let's just pick a random value. I'm going to do a 0x04. It could be anything that's not on or off should essentially cause an error condition to occur. And then let's restart our debug session to see when we get an error return from an off condition. All right, so we'll scan through. We start the debug session. And voila, so I'm going to scan through this fairly quickly because we want to get to the point where we're doing okay here. We're doing an on value, so we have a green LED. So now what we want to do is step through and see what happens with our bogus value. So we go through and we said, hey, do we have an LED off? Answer, no. All right, so do we have an LED on? Answer, also no. Now we have an error condition. So let's load an error condition and jump to exit, reset our stack frame and return. So now at this point, you can actually see here in the top left, you can actually see the error value of 1. And so what would happen now is if we keep going, we should essentially end out of our loop because we're no longer in a not error condition. So again, not super practical, but I just wanted to show you an example of returning an error code, how we could monitor all of this, watch all of our code and go through that. And one other thing that I want to go through here, I'm going to set this back to off. And and I want to do one more debug session so I can show you the peripheral section of the debugger. So let's get the debug session going here. And let's cycle through. I'm going to skip through the GPIO. All right, let's go through here. So the thing I wanted to show you here is this peripheral section. So here are all of the peripherals. And so you can either monitor these registers and memory addresses as we did, but what's really convenient is this GPIO register. And what you can see here as we go through is when we take the GPIO control address and we say, hey, let's load from into T1 the GPIO output value. Well, then if we basically look at this port, it's equal to zero. So we actually know that we're going to get a zero back. So I just wanted to show you that really quick because it's a really interesting way to be able to monitor the various peripherals and all of the different values that are going on. You can see there's other peripherals as you get more experience with controlling this board. This is another way to monitor your peripherals. So you can look at your registers, you can look at GPIO and the rest of the values, you can actually look at various memory, you can actually set some breakpoints through the code, and then of course if you're looking at C code, monitor your variables. So a lot of power here, but I wanted to just take a minute and show you that as well.